السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله الحي باقي الذي أضاء نوره الآفاق وتجلت رحمته إذ بلغت أرواحهم التراق ورزق المؤمنين حسن الأخلاق. نحمده تبارك وتعالى ونستعينه على الصعاب والمشاق، ونعوذ بنور وجهه الكريم من ظلمات الشك والشرك والشقاق، ونسأله السلامة من النفاق وسوء الأخلاق. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي العظيم الذي علم المتعلمين، والذي بعث الأمل في قلوب البائسين، فاللهم صل عليه صلاة توصلنا إليه وتقربنا من حضرته يوم الدين، يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. ثم أما بعد، السلام عليكم dear respected brothers and sisters. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the right way. O Allah, I told you I'm alone, and you told me in the Quran, do not despair of the mercy of Allah. Oh Allah, I told you nobody knows what's in my heart. You say in the Quran, verily, in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do heart find rest. Oh Allah, I told you many people helped me. You said in the Quran, so excuse them and ask for forgiveness for them. Oh Allah, I told you I feel that I'm alone and I feel the pain. You said in the Quran, we are closer to him than the jugular vein. Oh Allah, I told you my sins are so many. You told me in the Quran, and who can forgive the sins except Allah? Oh Allah, I told you, I'm facing a lot of problems, a lot of difficulties. You told me in the Quran, and whoever fears Allah, he will make for him a way out. Oh Allah, I told you, my Lord, I need hope. You said in the Quran, indeed, with hardship, you will find ease. Oh Allah, I told you I have many dreams. You said, call upon me, I will respond to you. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. If my servant asks you about me, I'm very near to them. ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all over everything. وقال ربكم ادعوني استجب لكم. Those who ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anything, make dua and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will respond to you. If you have any difficulties or any problems, remember that Allah is with you. Put in your mind every day, we all have too many things in our lives. We have too much depression, too many things in our mind. We are worried about our kids' future. We are worried about our businesses. We are worried about everything around us. But how come you worry about something and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوعَدُونَ. Your risk in the heavens will come to you. As the death will come to you, your risk will come to you. Don't worry. No one can deny death. No one can deny that. That we all know that one day we all gonna die. That you have to remember all the time and remind yourself, remind everyone around you that Allah will not put you down. The problem is from us. Why? Put trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He says, وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whoever fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will make a way out for you. وَمَن يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Whoever relies on Allah and depend on Allah, Allah will sufficient for you. Don't worry. The only thing is, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Allah created the jinn and the ins, except that to worship Him. This is the only part Allah wants from you. Then don't worry about anything else. I'm not saying sit home and say my rizq will come to me. No. You need to spend time. You need to put some effort. But don't put too many things in your heart. Your jawarih, your senses, has to work hard. But your heart has to have trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, inshallah, some reflections or some educational reflections in hadith al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he was sitting with his sahaba, with his friends, people around him, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's the best teacher. What did he say? Very famous hadith. And I mentioned that in Saturday after Fajr, but we're going to mention it with more details, because we do not have this number every Saturday in Salat al-Fajr. But I wish to see the masjid like Salat al-Jum'ah in Salat al-Fajr. We need everyone. There is no excuses for Salat al-Fajr. The balance of your day. The balance of your day is Salat al-Fajr. And I need you, inshallah, before I continue, your phones. I'm going to remind you all the time. Shut down your phone or make it silent. Please. Don't be busy with it. خلاص, we have to leave everything behind us. Once you enter the masjid, you say, Allahumma aftah li abwaba rahmatik. You ask Allah mercy. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open the door of mercy for you, before you. That's why everyone, when you come, please make sure, put your phone and don't let the phone control you. You have to control it. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه. This hadith was narrated by Abu Huraira. Authentic hadith. صحيح. Strong hadith. And he said, تدرون من المفلس? Do you know the one who bankrupt? Everyone know the bankrupt, the one who doesn't have money. The one who's like me, mashallah, nothing. Said, how come? I have everything. Who said I'm poor or I don't have? You have to tell yourself that I'm not poor. You have to tell yourself that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who put you in this situation. If you want to look at someone who has, look at the one who doesn't have. If you look at someone who has big car and two cars, you have one car, alhamdulillah. If you have a house, say alhamdulillah. Because some people do not even have food to eat. That's why you have to thank Allah all the time that alhamdulillah for whatever we have. I need it from your heart. Alhamdulillah. That's why we need everyone to put this kind of trust and say alhamdulillah for whatever I have in my life, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says kulla yawmin huwa fi sha'n. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises some people and puts some people like in different situation or a different status. Everyone, sometimes you see someone who doesn't have, after mashallah, a couple of days or a couple of weeks, couple of years, mashallah, he has a lot. And all of us, mashallah, came from back home, we don't have anything. Now, mashallah, we have business, we have houses, we have cars, everyone have car. But still said, no, I need. Yes, we need to have hope, but at the same time, remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, في حديث الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم عندما قال, قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم إن من الناس amongst the people, some people, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them rich, their situation will be different. إن من الناس من أفكرهم الله لفسد حاله. Some people, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them rich, they will be destructive, they will be a different way. And some another people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He make them poor, they will switch. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants everything to be stable. If everyone is rich, who gonna take care of the garbage? Who gonna take care of sweeping the streets? If everyone rich, who gonna bring some stuff for you, the house? Who gonna make so and so and so? And if everyone is poor, what do you think? Who gonna take care of those poor people? That's why we have balance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْأَرْضَ وَضَعَهَا لِلْأَنَامِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it for everyone. وَأَقِيمُ الْوَزْنَ بِالْقِسْطِ الْقِسْطِ الْعَدْلِ Justice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has justice to everyone. And don't ever think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala against anyone. Allah is with you, but the only thing, trust in Him. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم to his friend, أتدرون من المفلس؟ Do you know the bankrupt? They said, yes. المفلس فينا من لا درهم له ولا متاع. المفلس, the bankrupt amongst us, the one who doesn't have money. ولا متاع. Not even property. He doesn't have even house. Then Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم right away. He is the best teacher. He has to correct them. He has to correct them. He said, no, this is not the bankrupt. The bankrupt, the really one, or the one who is bankrupt before Allah, listen to that. And this hadith is very important. Everyone has to look into each word in this hadith. You could be one of them. But you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from you. He said, المفلس من أمتي, the bankrupt, amongst my ummah, or amongst my people, or in my ummah, the one who comes with, count with me, يوم القيامة, on the day of judgment, on the day of resurrection, on the day when everyone stand before Allah, nothing you have except your actions. You will not have money, you will not have gold, you will not have cars, you will not have houses, you will leave all of these things behind you. You will come alone. لقد جئتمونا فرادا. You will come individual before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كما خلقناكم أول مرة. As He created you the first time. You remember when someone born from his mother comes to this dunya? The mother deliver you small, nothing. You don't have anything. But subhanallah, Allah took care of you and give you whatever you want. He said, the one who comes on the day of judgment with one, salah, someone who comes with a lot of salah, praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making nawafil, all of his salawat is good. طيب, wasiyam, fasting, sawm, he fast, mashallah, wazaka, giving charity, giving zakah, wayati waqad shatama hadha. This is the disaster here. He comes with a lot of ibadat. He comes with a lot of salawat. He comes with a lot of siyam, sawm, fasting. And he comes with zakah, giving charity, giving sadaqat, giving donation, giving here and there. But you know, all of these things will not help you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيْتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَ وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ وَفِي آيَةٍ أُخْرَى إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ. Your salah, if your salah does not forbid you to do evil or to do shameful, your salah is not valid. Your salah is not acceptable. Why? Because Islam is not only ibadat. Islam is not only worship. Islam is mu'amalat. And we all know that we have in fiqh, we have ibadat, worship, good deeds, salah, zakah, siyam. And we have mu'amalat, dealings, to deal with others. And we have hudud, rules. You cannot just come to the masjid and you do not follow the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His masjid or in His house. You can't come to salah and you read Quran and you deal with the people with bad way. You cheat others and you think this is, you know, no one can see me. You hide, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَخْفَى عَلَيْهِ شَيْءٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing will be hidden before Him. He knows everything. Then when you come with salah, and on the day of judgment with zakah, then your siyam, your ibadat, then you come, وَقَدْ شَتَمَ هَذَا. You curse people. مُعَمَلَاتَ. Now we left our ibadat to move to our mu'amalat, our dealing. وَيَأْتِي وَقَدْ شَتَمَ هَذَا وَقَذَفَ هَذَا وَسَفَكَ مَلَ دَمَ هَذَا وَأَكَلَ مَالَ هَذَا. You curse others. Then you are taking the money of others. Then you talk about others, backbiting, slandering. Then ظلم. You come and you have ظلم toward someone. And I told you last time in my khutbah, in our communities, no exception, we have problems. And I'm trying my best to focus in these problems in the communities. Khutab here, we need to feel that we are facing the reality. We need to talk about the reality in our communities. We need to talk about the facts in our communities. Do you want to talk about how do you give salah, to make salah, and how do you give zakah, and the people they are behind that. We need everyone to understand that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to speak about everything and the member. Why? Because if we do not teach people from here, when are you going to teach them? We're going to go to their houses? No. Al-Jum'ah Jama'ah is to teach them something. What they are facing. What's the problem to solve it? We need our kids to understand that the masajid is not only for salah and for reading Quran and for ibadat. Salah is, the masjid is university to learn everything. And this is what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he established al-masjid in Medina, masjid was everything for the Muslim community back then. And that's why we need everyone to understand that. Then he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who comes with zakah and salah and zakah, وَقَدْ شَتَمَ هَذَا وَقَذَفَ هَذَا. Shatam, cursing. What about qadaf? Someone is making qadaf means someone who is talking about others without any evidence. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اجْتَنِبُوا كَثِيرًا مِنَ الظَّنِّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, avoid this kind of dhan, suspicion. Someone, one day, happened with Prophet Muhammad himself. One day he was walking with his wife. Then one of the people, he was a little bit late. He doesn't want to like put Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in suspicion. Prophet Muhammad right away, he saw him. He said, come. Why this man is thinking about it? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's smart. And every mu'min has to be this way. As Sayyidina Muhammad said, al-mu'min kayyis fatin. Al-mu'min is smart. You do not just let everything go like that. You know, you have to understand everything when someone is talking to you. When you deal with someone, you have to catch it right away. Don't think after like 2 days. Prophet Muhammad right away, at the same moment, he called the man. He said, come, this is my wife, Aisha. Why? He said, Prophet Muhammad, I know. No, he said, no. Because he want to remove any doubt from his heart before he goes outside and make problems. Like what happened with Sayyida Aisha. When the people start talking about Sayyida Aisha, she was with Safwan. Why? Because Safwan was taking care of the kafila, the group. Then after the kafila left, or the group left, or the caravan left, she was doing something and she came back, she didn't find anyone. Safwan used to take care of the caravan or the group after they leave. If someone left something or someone lost, he found Sayyida Aisha by herself. What happened? She said, when I came back, I didn't find anyone. And Sayyida Aisha was thin. She wasn't fat. When they put her in the howdaj on the top of the camel, they felt that she is in the howdaj. But she was not. Then they left. And Sayyida Aisha by herself. Safwan, when he went to check everything after they left, he found Sayyida Aisha and he brought her back to the qafila. One of the people saw him. Oh my goodness, this is what happened in our community. When we sit in jama'ah, when we have gathering, when we eat together in the house, when we have some tea. Wallahi, so Sheikh Walid was doing something yesterday. I saw so and so. and you make it like rumors, you know, إشاعات. And you keep talking about something without even evidence. You don't know what's happening. Wallah, it's happened with me. When someone called my wife, you imagine that? Someone called my wife, you know, sister, where's Sheikh Waleed? He's not here. I saw him with one of the ladies. MashaAllah. And I was in the masjid giving lecture. I said, SubhanAllah. Then when I came back, I did not know that. Because Alhamdulillah, when you have trust, and you and your wife have trust, خلاص. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ Allah will defend those who believe, those who have iman. Then subhanAllah, my wife, she was laughing. She said, where are you? I said, what's this kind of question you ask me? She said, because so and so. I said, just if she called you, inshallah, tell her, Jazakumullah khair, sister. Don't open the door for them. Then she called, subhanAllah, said, I'm sorry, it wasn't Sheikh Waleed. MashaAllah, it was who? Someone else? You're going to talk about him? We don't want to spread the isha'ah. We don't want to say like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in Surah An-Nur. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحِبُّونَ أَن تَشِيعَ الْفَاحِشَ Those who like the fahisha, the shameful to be spread in the community. لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ They will have severe punishment in this dunya before the hereafter. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, forgive them. فَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى مَنْ عَلَى اللَّهِ Whoever asks for forgiveness for his brother or his sister, the reward will be from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he said, the one who comes and talk about others, وَأَكَلَ مَالَ هَذَا This kind of hadith contains a lot of lessons. Each word here we can make khutab, speeches and lectures. وَأَكَلَ مَالَ هَذَا You know, and I told you last time when we have partnership, we have a business together. We have no trust with each other. And I'm saying, before you establish any business, come sit with the sheikh. Before you do anything, and write it. Write every single thing. Why? دَرْءًا لِلْفِتْنَ وَدَرْءًا لِلْمَشَاكِلِ To avoid the problems and to avoid, subhanAllah, Allah says that in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا تَدَيَّنْتُمْ بِدَيْنٍ إِلَى أَجَلٍ مُسَمًّى فَاكْتُبُوهُ Write it. If you own someone, if you took loan from someone, don't say, وَاللَّهِ خُلِدْ I trust him. No, I do not trust myself. Put something. This is what Allah says. Because Allah knows our situation more than anyone else. Then, do you have the problems because of that? That's why when you take money from someone else without any rights, without any haqq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you about it. That's why when we said, on the day of judgment, you're going to pass the straight path, as-sirat al-mustaqim. In each station, you will be asked for it. What the station? The first one, as-salah. Your salah is the first station to be asked. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أول ما يسأل عنه العبد يوم القيامة الصلاة Your salah is gonna be the first thing to be asked when they put you in the grave. First thing. فإذا صلحت صلح سائر العمل If your salah is good, everything will be good. And I told you last time also because this we have big relation between last time and today. I'm trying to take it like series, then we continue. We said that the ignorant, not the one who doesn't know how to write, not the one who doesn't know how to read, but the ignorant is the one who knows the Qibla and he does not put his head on the floor and makes it to Allah. This is the ignorant. Right? That's why we need everyone to put each word from this hadith in his mind and to think about it. Then your station, Salah, Zakah, Hajj, Ibadat, until the last station. Khalas. Your train is going to go to the garage now. What's the garage now? Khalas, you have to pass this station. It's al-mazalim. If you were not fair with someone, if you have zulm toward anyone, especially your wife. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم ما أكرمهن إلا كريم. The one who takes care of his wife is كريم, generous. And خير الصدقة, the best sadaqah is when you give it to your ahl, your family, your wife. And the best luqma, ta'am, food,
To feed others is to feed your wife. Why? Because the problems of the communities or the problems of the families start from the house. When there is no understanding between the father and the mother or the husband and the wife, the disasters will be a lot. Or the musibah will be a lot. Or the problems will be a lot. Why? Because our kids, they lose their way. That's why we need to understand the hadith and al-mazalim. If you took anything from anyone, don't wait to come on the day of judgment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, continue the hadith. After you do everything, your salawan, your ibadat, and you come, you eat someone's money, or you take someone's money, and you curse someone, you talk out someone, or you hit, or you paid someone, Allah will come and say, give your brother or your sister his or her right. Then you will say, I don't have. Then Allah will take from your hasanat to him or to her. Now you don't have more hasanat or sayyat. What are you going to do now? They will give you from their sayyat, from bad deeds. This is the one who is bankrupt. The one who lost the hasanat and he has only sayyat from others, not only from himself. He will receive a lot of sayyat from others. His account will be full with sayyat. This is the time when Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting with his companions and he told them, do you know this is the bankrupt? They said, oh my goodness, everyone has to look into his action now. Everyone has to be careful because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-adl, justice. And he says in Hadith al-Qudusi, inni harramtu al-zulma ala nafsi waja'altuhu baynakum muharraman fala tadhalamu. I made zulm, oppression, or injustice, unlawful, haram, forbidden, upon myself, Allah says. And I made it haram upon all of you. Don't have zulm to each other. Look, wallahi, when we have this kind of hub and mawadda and love for the sake of Allah, the community will go up. But when we have always hatred and envy and jealousy in our hearts, what do you expect from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? لا يؤمن أحد. The one who considers a true believer is the one who loves for others whatever he loves for himself. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our hearts. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to be among those who bankrupt. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the right way. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us help to continue his ibadat in his way. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from our brothers and sisters who passed away. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give shifa to those who are sick. Jazakum Allah khayran. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We just did the announce today, inshallah. I'm taking everything today, inshallah. Yeah, the announce, inshallah, as we all know, inshallah, tomorrow, 6 o'clock, we have event from our youth, YM. They are inviting one of the guest speakers, his name, Brother Kaiser Aslam. Brother Kaiser, mashallah, he help a lot the communities. And I need everyone, inshallah, to do your best to come. Raising the next generation. We need everyone. I'm not doing something in the masjid just to have programs. It's something beneficial, something to learn from. Please bring your family and come more, inshallah, 6 o'clock. There will be, food, and inshallah, after Salat al-Asha, I think. I need, inshallah, everyone to be part of that. When we have something in the masjid, try to bring your family. Try to bring your kids. When you grow up with the community, with each other, wallahi, this is something you not know it now. In the future, you will see it. And we need everyone, inshallah, to spread the word. If any program in any masjid, try. If you have time, go. Don't say no. The second thing is, the halaqat also. We have, mashallah, halaqat for the youth, 7 to 14, every Friday, 6:30. And we have the YM, 7 o'clock. We have the sisters, halaqa, every Friday, 6:30.
And we have the halaqah Saturday for tajweed for the sisters. We have, mashallah, a lot of things. You need to know about it. Because there is no excuses. When you come and you say, wallahi, I do not know. There is no excuse for that. And inshallah, the last thing is, as we the keep mentioning, I did not want to mention that, but they tell me as one of the announce. As we know that, alhamdulillah, I'm going Umrah, inshallah, at the end of March. Whoever, inshallah, interested to come, inshallah, I will be with the group, inshallah. And portion of the money goes to the masjid, inshallah. Whoever comes through Dar al-Islah, we have portion to the masjid, inshallah. Do you have anything else? Yeah. Oh, mashallah. The new center, inshallah, the community will promise. It will be next Saturday? Oh, mashallah. This, inshallah, this weekend, inshallah. It's a good thing for the community to have Muslim community center. It will be in promise, inshallah. I think it costs 5 million, I think, or something. We need your help as much as you can. You come, inshallah, Saturday is going to be from 3 o'clock to 6, I think. From 3 to 6. 1 o'clock. 1 to 4, inshallah, this event to help our brothers. And this is for all Muslims in the area. For everyone, inshallah, to do your best, inshallah, to help. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our kids. And something for them, inshallah, they will have gym, they will have a swimming pool, they will have something to sit together. It's something we need in the community. We need, alhamdulillah, we have enough masajid, to be honest. We have enough masajid, and we need community centers, and we need Islamic schools. More than the masajid now, we need community centers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help them and give support to them. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all to the right way. Jazakumullah khairan.